now welcome a brilliant musician, 7-time Grammy winner, John Mayer. He performed Human Nature at today's memorial at the request of the Jackson family, played brilliant guitar, didn't sing today, and didn't... What an honor it must have been. You didn't know Michael, and the family invites you.
It's a why me sort of a situation, yeah.
What did you say?
Well, the first thing I said was a question was, does this really come from the family? I think that was essential to me sort of processing the honor, you know? And when I found out that, in fact, it had, it took me about 48 hours to sort of strike the balance in how I was going to approach being, you know, being invited to this unbelievable event without actually having the proximity to Michael Jackson personally. I'd never met
him. That's what added to it, though. Yeah. What did he mean to you then, performer to performer?
Oh, wow. You know, I come from a generation that sort of gets told one way or another that we're born at the wrong time. You know, people say, you should have had it 20 years ago. You could have done this and that and that. And to know that, you know, in my early years and in my generation's early years, you know, we were handed sort of down through MTV and the radio something like Thriller. Imagine your first record, because you know, you don't pick music the first 5 years that, you know, you're running around as a little kid. You know, the TV and the radio picks music for you. And what a blessing to have the music that just streams through in your house be a masterwork. You know, that was my connection to it, I think. That's what allowed me to walk up to the stage and feel.
And did you? John performed an instrumental version of Michael's Human Nature. Let's hear some of it. You like playing guitar as much as singing?
I like it more.
More?
Yeah, I don't have a great vocal range. And in fact, it's actually helped me out in songwriting. I don't know, I have to write my own songs to be able to appreciate or get anything out of my pretty limited vocal range. But on the guitar, I'm able to sort of, it's limitless for me. It's as long as the neck is, so I can go anywhere I want. And the decision to not sing is just out of, I think, knowing what's best for me. I think it's quite a minefield to go into trying to, in any way, replicate vocally what Michael Jackson has done. And in a way, was sort of respectfully leaving an absence, you know, sort of the presence of his absence in a tune. Yeah. You know?
What do you think of Usher's voice?
Unbelievable.
He was unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
Usher gave a moving performance. He sang Gone Too Soon. Walk down to the casket, watch.
Like a comet blazing across the evening sky. Gone too soon. Like a rainbow fading in a twinkling eye.
When he walked down to the casket?
Very moving, you know? I mean, everybody had a different relationship. He sings as if there was a real personal bond there, but I don't know. I mean, but that's the magic of music, is that that's all you need to know.
What did you think of the whole thing today?
All I could keep thinking, other than, you know, just sharing the why me with my fans and, you know, representing them, was how humanizing it was. You know, Michael Jackson wasn't superhuman. He was extra human, but nobody's superhuman. And I think everybody who watched the service, I think by the end of it, the best service of all was the service done to Michael Jackson to sort of render him finally as being a human being. you know? Well, did you feel that when you were there?
Yeah, oh, well said. Did you Twitter about it yet?
You know what? I didn't. Again.
Oh, John.
You know what? I didn't do any. I'm just trying to be, again, respecting the proximity or lack thereof to Michael Jackson. And we are connected through our music.
You sure are.
When my grandmother died several years ago, she was a nurse in her younger years. And she was lucky enough to be the last in her world to go, which meant it was a pretty empty funeral. Mm-hmm. And right in the middle, there were two registered nurses, way too young to have ever worked with her. But the hospital had sent two nurses because they were connected as nurses. And that's sort of what I referenced in allowing myself to enjoy being there without saying, why are you here?
You know? Smartest thing they did, yeah. Inviting you.
Thank you.
Thank you, John.
Thank you.
John Mayer. The great Harry Belafonte, there's only one. One of the musical powers behind We Are the World speaks for the first time publicly about the death of his friend Michael Jackson next.